All right, welcome to the descriptive narrative essay. So basically what we're doing with this, we're taking two different types of essays that feed so well into each other and we're combining them, okay? So sometimes you write descriptive essays, sometimes you write narrative essays. We're going to write one that is a descriptive narrative essay, okay? This is one of my favorite forms of creative writing. It's actually called, typically, in the format that we're writing it, since it's going to be in short form, it would be a nonfiction flash essay is what this would be called. Originally it was called an essaykin, which I think is like a cooler name, but you know, whatever, that lost out. So now it's called nonfiction flash. But with that, what you're going to do is you're going to take really trying to find like a dominant person, place, thing, and weaving a story around that object or that person or that place, and telling us a story that really drives what you feel most powerfully about that individual or that place, about that noun, okay? And so with a narrative essay, you're not gonna have a direct thesis statement. So what you have instead is what's called a dominant impression. And so as we're reading this work, we should have an idea of what it is that you feel about whatever it is you're writing about. And that's the main thing, and we'll talk more about this when I get back. But the main thing to keep in mind as you are doing this is you are not just telling us a story. You are showing us something. You are making us experience it the way that you experience it. So let's just be honest. I have no direct feelings one way or another about, like, say, your grandparents. Okay, I'm sure they're wonderful people, but I have never had any actual interactions with them. I have no opinion of them, and so I don't have any kind of feeling about them whatsoever. Okay. This kind of sound weird that I just said I don't have feelings for your grandparents, but you guys know what I'm saying. So what your responsibility is in this essay is you want me to come away from that feeling exactly what you feel about these people that I have never met before, all right? And so when I come away, I should be laughing, or I should be crying, or I should be whatever, okay? And there's, honestly, I cry a lot with these essays because people always pick sad stuff. You don't have to, okay? You can pick happy things as well. But whatever it is that you feel most deeply, pour that out on a page. That's what you're doing with this essay. In the syllabus, I have some prompts that might get you going in case you're stuck, but that's the big picture of what you're trying to do, okay? So it's gonna be about 3 to 5 pages. It will be written in either third or first person. This is the only essay that I allowed that first person point of view to come in. You are gonna use some specific types of figurative language, so that's listed there for you. Make sure you're using those similes, metaphors, and personifications just to make sure that you understand how those are gonna work. And you will then use that same self-grade that you just did for assignment zero to score yourself on what you think, how well you think you did on this particular essay, okay? So I have some different points there we're gonna jump into whenever I get back, kind of talking about making sure that you come kind of in the middle of things so that you're not just trying to tell every single thing. You're only telling the details to feed that dominant impression. But I'm not gonna get into that right now so that you have time to just sort of think about it. So what I want you to do today is, there is on the assignment sheet here, there's an essay called Not a House. Okay, that's a shorter version of what you're going to be writing. And so tomorrow you're going to read that, and that's going to give you some ideas of what I'm kind of looking for. I'm also going to let you look at some other websites that have some of these, so that will give you an idea of what to do. For today, though, I want you to just brainstorm some of the descriptive language that you know. Okay, like really try and like describe as much as you possibly can, either outside or inside, depending on what Ms. Herbert wants you to do. And then as time allows, I also want you to do our standard game plan stuff. So check that out. Enjoy it. Love it. If you have any questions, please let me know. And as always, have a great day. Make wise decisions and Merry Christmas.